students, a warm welcome to the Gurudeva e-learning classes. In our today's class, we gonna discuss about the word problems, means word problems on multiplication. Okay? Yes. Before going to our today's class, let us recall about our previous class. What we have discussed in our previous class? Yes, we have discussed about the multiplication of two-digit number by a one-digit number, isn't it? Yes. See, first one, read the question. 2 into 23, or we can read it as 2 23s are dash. How to do this problem? Look at here. Listen carefully. Okay. First, you have to multiply the ones place digit first. Okay. 2 into 3. Now, you remember the table of 2. 2 1 is 2. 2 2s are 4. 2 3s are what? 2 3s are 6. Write down this 6 under the ones column. You have to write this 6 under the ones column. And next to the tens part, you have to multiply this 2 again. Okay. 2 into 2. You remember the table of 2? 2 1 is 2. 2 2s are what? 2 2s are 4. Write down this 4 under the ones column. Write down this 4 under the tens column. And write down the 6 under the ones column. Then what is our product? Our product is 46. See, this is all about our first question. Now let us move on to the second question. See, here is our second question. In this, we read the question as 333s are dash. 333s are dash. How to do this multiplication? See, first you have to multiply these two numbers. See, our second step is that you have to multiply the ones place numbers first, isn't it? Yes. See, therefore, 3 3s are dash. Now, you remember the table of 3. See, 3 1 is 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 3 3s are 9. Write down this 9 under the ones column. You have to write down this 9 under the ones column. This completes our ones part. Now we have to calculate the tens part. See, you have to again multiply this 3 along with this 3. Okay. See, 3 into 3. See, 3 3s are what I said before, 9. Again the product is 9. Write down this 9 under the tens column. Okay. See, now the product is 99. 99 is the product of second question. Yes, dear children, until now we have recalled about our previous class. In the today's class, we gonna discuss about the word problems in multiplication. In multiplication, how we are doing the word problems, all those things let us learn in our today's class. Okay? Yes. Yes, dear children, you have already done the word problems using addition and subtraction in your first semester, isn't it? Here, we are going to do the word problems on multiplication, or using multiplication, how to solve the word problems. Okay? See, here is the example number 1. Okay? If there are 2 eggs in each box, how many eggs are there in 3 boxes? Once again, I will read out the question. Okay. If there are 2 eggs in a box. See, how many eggs in a box? There are 2 eggs in box. How many eggs are there in 3 boxes? See, in one box, if there is 2 eggs, like that, in the same way, 3 boxes has how many eggs? Whenever you start reading the question, first, you have to read the question twice or thrice. Until you understand the question, don't go to answer the question. See, solution, you have to answer the word problems in these steps. Okay. See, first one, number of eggs in each boxes. In each boxes, there are how many eggs? See, there are 2 eggs. Write down this 2. 2 is the single digit number. You should write that 2 under the ones column. Okay. In the same way, second one, number of boxes. How many boxes are there totally? See, there are 3 boxes totally, isn't it? Write down this 3 under the 1's column, because 3 is again a single digit number. Therefore, you write this 3 under the 1's column, okay? And next, you put the sign of multiplication, that is into. You put the sign of multiplication into, okay? Yes. And next, you already know 3 into 2 or 3 2's are what? 3 2's are dash. Now, you have to remember the table of 3. 3 1 is 3. See here. 3 1 is 3. 3 2's are what? 3 2's are 6. Here see. 3 2's are 6. Here is 6. Write down this 6 under the 1's column. You have to write this product under the 1's column. See, now third point, total number of eggs in 3 boxes. Totally in 1 box there are 2 eggs. Like that, in the 3 box there will be a 6 eggs. Okay. After writing these 3 statements, this last statement is very very important. Whenever you write the test, then you have to write these points. Okay. These 3 points along with this last point. See, this symbol indicates therefore. Okay. There are 6 eggs in 3 boxes. This is the very very important statement that you have to write in every questions. Okay. If you write only until this, we will get only the half mark. If you write the full, then you will get full mark for that question. Okay. See, once again, I will read out the question and I will tell how to answer the question. Listen carefully. Okay. See, if there are 2 eggs in each box, how many eggs are there in 3 boxes? See, in a single box, if there are 2 eggs, means 3 box has how many eggs? That is the question. Okay. Answer, solution. First point, number of eggs in each box. Single box has how many eggs? 2 eggs. Okay. We have written 2 here. In the same way, second point is number of boxes. How many number of boxes are there here? 3 boxes. Therefore, we have written 3 here. In the same way, total number of eggs in 3 boxes. Totally, in these 3 boxes, how many eggs are there? That is our answer we have to find out. Okay? That is 6, because 3 2's are 6. Okay? After writing these 3 points, the main important point is last one. This sign indicates therefore. If we put 3 dots, that indicates therefore. Okay? Yes. There are 6 eggs in 3 boxes. We have already now know that after solving the problem, there are 6 eggs in 3 boxes. If one box has 2 eggs, then 3 box will having 6 eggs. That is our product. The product of the first example is 6. Okay, dear children? Yes. Now we have already solved the example number 1, right? This is the homework problem. See, I have changed the numbers here. Number of eggs are 5 and number of boxes are 2. This problem you have to solve it in your assignment book. Okay? You must and should solve this problem in your assignment book. Okay? Yes. Dear children, now let us move on to the example number 2. Okay? Yes. Second question. If there are 4 books in each bag, how many books are there in 5 bags? This is our question. Once again, I will read out the question. Listen carefully. Okay? If there are 4 books in each bag has 4 books. Means, every bag will have 4 books. Then, how many books are there in 5 bags? Means, totally there are 5 bags. Means, one bag will have 4 books. Then, totally 5 bags are having how many number of books? That is our question. Okay. How to solve this? See, can you see the bag on the board? See, in this bag there are how many books? Count the books. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here there is one bag. The bag has 4 books. And our question is to find the number of books in 5 bags. See, 5 bags. Can you see now? Yes. In 5 bags also, the total number of books that we have to find out in our second one. Okay. How to solve this by using the sentences? Now, I will write down. Okay. Look at the board carefully. See, dear children, you have to remember one point. Before answering the question, you have to first understand what is there in the question. Okay. See, first point, number of books in each bag. Each bag has how many number of books? 4 number of books. Write down this 4 under the ones column. Because 4 is the single digit number, therefore you write down this 4 under the ones column. Okay. Our second point, number of bags. There are how many number of bags? Totally there are 5 bags. Write down this 5 under the ones column. Because 5 is also a single digit number, therefore you write down this under the ones column. And you should not forget to write the sign of multiplication, that is into. Okay. See, this is the way of writing the 2 points. Next, 5 into 4. 5 into 4 means 5 fours are dash. See, now you remember the table of 5. 5 1 is 5. 5 2s are 10. 5 3s are 15. 5 4s are 20. What is the 5 4s? 5 4s are 20. See, 20 is the 2 digit number. 0 is under the 1's place and 2 is under the 10's place. You have to write this 0 under the 1's column and you have to write this 2 under the 10's column. Okay. See, 5 4s are 20. By knowing the tables of 5, we have written that 5 4s are 20. Okay. See, by writing these 3 points, this last point is very, very important. Therefore, there are 20 books in 5 bags. See, there are totally 20 books in 5 bags. See, one single bag has 4 books means 5, total 5 bags are having 20 books. See, the product is 20. Now, I will give you homework that you have to solve it in your assignment book. Okay? Yes. See, this is the homework problem. If there are 3 books in each bag, how many books are there in 4 bags? If one bag has 3 books, then 4 bag will have how many number of books? That is your question. Okay? That you have to solve by step. Okay? You need not to forget to write this last step. Okay? You must and should solve this homework problem. Okay? Yes. Yes. Third one. If cost of one water bottle is rupees 10. See, this is the symbol of representing the money. It will come in your next lesson, that is money lesson. Okay. Then you will go in detail about this sign. Now you only identify the symbol. Okay. See, if the cost of one water bottle is rupees 10, then find the cost of 4 water bottles. See, if one water bottle cost is 10 rupees, then what is the cost of 4 water bottles? Obviously, it is 40 rupees. How to solve this using the word problems by writing the sentences? Let us see now. Okay. See, before going to that, see, can you see the water bottle on the board? Yes, one water bottle cost is 10 rupees. Like that, 4 water bottles cost is 40. How to solve that? Look at here. Okay? Yes. See, before solving the problem, you have to understand the question first. Okay? See, one water bottle cost is 10 rupees. Then 4 water bottle cost is how much? That is our question. Okay? See, here, first one. Cost of one water bottle. What is the cost of one water bottle? What is the cost? Yes, very good. The cost of one water bottle given here is 10 rupees. 10 is the two digit number. Write down the 0 under the 1's column and 1 under the 10's column. Okay. Second point, number of water bottles. Total number of water bottles are 4. 4 is the single digit number. You have to write this 4 under the 1's column. Okay. Here we have to do the multiplication. Therefore, you put the sign of multiplication, that is into. Okay. Yes. How to do this multiplication? You already well known about the multiplication, right? 4 into 0. See, you remember the one important point that when you multiply any number with 0, then the product will be 0. See, 4 into 0 is 0. 4 into 0 is 0. And next, you have multiplied this 4 by 0. And next step, you have to multiply this 4 by 1. 4 into 1. Now, you have to remember the table of 4. 4, 1 is what? 4, 1 is 4. Write down this 4 under the 10's column. Okay. See, our first step is you have to multiply this 4 with 0 and then you have to write the answer. And next, again you have to multiply this 4 by 1. Again you write the answer under the 10's column. Okay. See, third one, total cost of water bottles is 40. Total cost of 4 water bottles is 40. Next, the last important is, therefore, the cost of 4 water bottle is rupees 40. Therefore, the cost of 4 water bottle is rupees 40. Okay. See, I will give you your homework. You should solve it in your assignment book. Okay. See, dear children, this is the homework problem. If the cost of 1 water bottle is rupees 5. One water bottle cost is 5 rupees. Then find the cost of 9 water bottles. In the same way, what is the cost of 9 water bottles? That is our question. By writing like this same question sentences, you have to solve the word problem. Okay? Yes. See, there are two important points that you have to remember in your multiplication. See, in that first point is, whenever you multiply the number with 0, whenever you multiply the number with 0, the product will be the 0 itself. Neevu yavade number na 0 ottige multiply madidrunu product en barutte 0 barutte. In the same way, the second point is 0 into 4 is equal to 0. If you multiply the 0 with any number, the product will be the 0. See, neevu yavaga 0 ottige yavade number multiply madidrunu ve product will be the 0. See, first point is, whenever you multiply the number with 0, the product will be the 0 itself. Or the answer will be the 0 itself. In the same way, if you multiply the 0 with any number, the product will be again a 0. Okay. These are the two important points that you have to remember while you are multiplying the two numbers. Okay. Yes. Yes, dear children. Now let us solve the exercise number 2.7. See, that is in the page number 86. All of you open your page number 86. There is an exercise number 2.7. In that, be made. It is in the black thick lines. I will read out it. You listen carefully. Read and solve. Read and solve. Here there are totally 6 questions. I will solve one by one. Listen carefully. Okay. Yes. Yes, dear children. Remaining problems in your exercise, you have to solve it in your assignment book. Okay. Yes. And while solving the problems, I have given you homework, right? Those problems and these problems, both you have to solve it in your assignment book. Okay? Yes, dear children, I hope you all understood the today's class. Let us meet in the next class with a new concept and very interesting concept. Thank you. Bye, children.